Okay, what we have is a completed texture map for our character. You can spend more time if you want. For example, if you want to add more details, that's completely up to you. In my case, I'm actually happy with this, so we're going to export each of these maps and then preview it in a program called Marmoset. So before we do that, let's start exporting each one. Just make sure you have the diffuse here and you are happy with, well, basically everything. I might turn off the base down there so I don't actually accidentally capture it. All right, let's go ahead, save as. I'm going to save it as a target file. And then we'll go and replace the defuse file right there. All right, next, let's go to gloss. We'll go over here, save target file. We'll put G as the postfix. That'll be a new, brand new little map there. Next, go to specularity, same deal. I'm gonna put S on the end. Done. All right, let's have a quick review of the textures. We have the diffuse, the gloss, normal map, and specularity. That's pretty much ready to go. This is the skin, we still have to do the head. But what I wanna do is show you guys how you can preview this in a physical-based renderer. Now what I have here is something called Marmoset Toolbag. And what this is basically going to help us is it's just going to help us read or preview the character that we have. Now in a similar fashion to what we've done in Dido, we need to bring in the meshes and, well, just the mesh and then the materials. So I'm going to start here. Let's go ahead and import mesh. So file, import mesh. And we're going to import the same mesh we had used for Dido. Okay, so that's the mesh we have. And you can also navigate around this, and this is all in real time too. All right. So it's using physical-based rendering. The other thing you can do is play around with the skybox. So if you go to scene and sky browser, it's got a few default ones, and this is great to test your lighting just to make sure the reflections are looking great. All right. And I do have to emphasize, by the way, that if you're going to render this in Mental Ray, the result will be very different. Right? That's just how the renderers are. So with the skybox sort of set to that, I'm actually select a different one. So let's go to Sky Browser again. I'll try something a little bit brighter. I think that one would be nice. Maybe we can try this one. No, that's a bit too weird. Okay, that's fine. We'll just start with Late Day. What I want to do is create a new material. You can use that if you want. I'm just gonna go new material. That's the new material right here. And this is for previewing purposes. So if you want to rename it for yourself, that's fine. And it's very simple. Okay, we've got our maps ready. Let's go ahead and add a normal map. So just click that, go to texture and add your normals. And you can't really see that yet, that's fine. Let's go down here and I'm gonna go down to albedo because that will be the diffuse. Albedo is also known as diffuse, for those who are doing a lot of rendering. So albedo. Oh, forgot one thing. I was supposed to drag and drop it onto our mesh here. There we go. That's better. I was wondering why it wasn't showing up. Okay, so drag and drop the material onto your mesh. All right, albedo is there. We've got our normal maps. I'm going to add a gloss map. So gloss is there. Okay. And finally, we also have specularity. So let's go down to reflectivity here. And click that and bring in the specular map. And that's our model. All right, which is looking, in my opinion, fantastic. If we zoom in, we can also see all these tiny details we added, like the metal buckles. It's got some good reflectivity off there. Same over here. It's making this pop out a lot, and I'm really loving it. So you've even got the nails, the buttons that just hold the mesh back like that. And this is how people get all those tiny details on those big models. You may be wondering, wow, do they sculpt each one? Yeah, they can. But another way is utilizing stuff like Dido to get these results. I'm going to change my sky, something a little bit different. So dirt road, like that. And of course, if you want to make any adjustments, go back into Photoshop and start doing them. And by the way, I do know that thread is still there. I haven't fixed it. I've been a little bit lazy, but just for the sake of this tutorial, we'll call this segment done. Down here you can see more nails, the metal. Just blending in so well with everything, and even the thread is looking great. Looking really, really good. Very happy with this. See, even the threads on the pants. If I were to zoom out and look at my character, you can see he's very readable. Obviously, we don't have his arms and head yet. We're going to be doing some of that very, very shortly. And of course, if you want to add more detail, add change maybe the normal maps or whatever, go ahead and do that. Okay, let's take a look and see what we've got here. That button looks a bit weird, but I think it's okay. So there you have it. That's how you do texturing, and well, that's how you do very high detailed texturing. Let's have some fun with this. I might try a sky turntable. So have it spin around and just double check the quality of that amazing texture work. At least that's what I'll say to myself. All right, it's looking good. You can also play around with some of the render settings here. For example, we have local reflections, which I will turn on so that the reflections here will also reflect anything that's on the character rather than just the environment. Gives it a more realistic feel. What else do we have? We've got occlusion size, which is ambient occlusion. If I bring the occlusion strength up, you can see that's where the ambient occlusion is gathering. Now that by no means is a perfect ambient occlusion, because you get this slightly grainy feel, but that's okay. It'll still give you some pretty nice ambient occlusion renders there. So you can add a lot if you want to go for that very cartoonish, contrasty look. Also have high-res shadows, which I can turn on. That's really good for rendering it out. And that's basically it, I believe. I'm sure they have more. Air, water, no, I think I'll leave that there. But that's looking pretty much done. Down here on this side, you've got extra settings. For example, I might just leave emissive map out. I don't really need emissive map. I don't have any ambient occlusion maps because we've kind of baked the crevices in there. So we'll leave that out. I'll change the reflection. Let me change it to mirror and just have a play around with that so it's nice and shiny. Let me try GGX. It's probably not a good one. It's not getting a lot of detail. Anisotropic. It's not too bad. I'll just leave it at Blinn and Phong. Okay, Blinn and Phong, they're basically like very versatile material types. All right, hope this has been very useful for you guys. This is Marmoset, so just a quick preview of those who don't know how to, you know, render those weird models. And of course, you can pose your character out once we're done with the texturing on the head and the hands. Pose them out, put them back in here, and then create a render for yourself. So I believe you can save the file somewhere. I don't even know where it is. But anyway, you can. Apparently you can. Here we go. Image. Change the settings. But I think I'll just leave it like that. That's pretty good. So very happy with that. All right. And if you want to make any changes to your texture, go ahead and do that. The longer you take on the texturing aspect, the higher the details will be. Like I've always been saying, the faster you go, the less details there'll be. But the longer you take on a character, the more details you can add on there. This is, again, a very basic form of texturing. Hopefully this is enough for you to help you guys get started. I'm sure it's actually quite easy to get your head around all this stuff now, despite the fact that this is a fairly difficult tutorial. But with that, I'll leave you with it. Have fun with Marmoset Toolbag. Don't forget to support them, take a look at their software, and I'll see you in the next part of this texturing tutorial.